Where am I today? I wonder if anyone can figure it out. I am in a room in the school. It's a big room. There's lots and lots of furniture in it. I can see a rainbow. I can see windows, but not all the windows are on the outside of the building. There's three doors or three doorways, but only two of the doors have actual doors on them. There's a TV. There is an interactive board which is connected to the computer. There's plants. I can see a tiger. I can see hands. I can see the Gruffalo. There's lots of posters in this room. There's lots of chairs in this room, but they're not the kind of chairs that you would sit on in the classroom. There's a sofa. There's funny shaped sofas. I wonder where I am. I wonder how many of you got it right. So, here I am. Now, there behind me is the rainbow. There is the tiger. So, of course, I'm in the library in the ICT suite. So, there's the windows. But here's the windows that don't look out to the outside. There's the chairs that don't look like the chairs in your classroom. Here's the funny shaped couches. I like to call them the fidget spinner couches. And there is the other couch. So, well done to anyone who figured out that we were in the library. Now, I'm going to take my face mask off because there's nobody else around about me at the moment, so as you can see me. As I say, well done to anyone who got it right. Now, today's assembly, wow. In fact, the next month's assemblies, we're going to be busy because February is the start of Black History Month, but also LGBT History Month. Oh, who's this running up the stairs? Hello.
No, I don't want to be
Hiya,
here.
Dean.
I don't want to be here.
That's all right. Hi, Elise. You, give us a wave. Hi, Neve.
Bye.
Bye. Oh, here's Joshua coming. You gonna give us a wave, Joshua?
Hi.
Hi. I'm concentrating so I don't fall down the stairs here, Joshua. They all love being in assembly, really. They wouldn't admit it. So yeah, so it's the start of Black History Month, LGBT History Month, and next week is also going to be Child Mental Health Week. And the theme for this year's Child Mental Health, last year it was about wearing your brave pants. Next week is Child Mental Health Week, and the theme is Express Yourself. So I've just been speaking to Philippa. Now, Philippa should be in her office. Oh no. Philippa's not in her office. Oh, hello, Mr. Monroe. Philippa's not in her office. I was going to get her to tell us a wee bit about it. But it's next week. So if you get activities from your teachers saying, Express yourself, then you know what it's all about. Mrs. Emma will be thinking, oh God, here she goes again. Oh no, she's not in her office. But today, we're going to talk about Black History Month and why Black History Month is so very important. As I said already, there's lots of things that we're going to look at over the course of the month of February, one of which is Black History Month. And this happens every single year. I want you to put your hand up if you have ever heard of Black History Month. Brilliant. Do you know what Black History Month is about? Tell your teacher what's it about. Well, let's find out what it is about. It's about a time for us to think about and celebrate the achievements of Black men and women in the past and in today. But why is that important?
Can you tell your teacher why you think that's important? It's important because throughout history, people have been treated differently because of the colour of their skin. Black people were not seen as equal and they weren't treated in the same way as white people because, for some reason, white people thought they were better than everyone else. Now, we know that that is absolute nonsense and nobody is better than anyone else because underneath the skin, every single one of us is exactly the same. But it was so bad in some parts of the world that they weren't even allowed to sit on certain seats in a bus. They weren't even allowed to go into the same shops as white people. So really, coloured and black people were really treated badly. And lots of people knew that it was wrong and they wanted things to change, but they were actually scared to do that because they were scared of what the people around about them would say if they stood up for black and coloured people. In 1926 in America, there was a man called Carter G. Woodson who introduced a Negro History Week, which later turned into Black History Month. And in 1987, the first ever Black History Month took place in the UK. Does anyone know why it is celebrated during the month of February in America? Because it takes place in the United Kingdom every year in October, and in America it's February. But why is it February? Sailors and Marines watch a dance performance during Black History Month in the celebration picture just at the side there. Did anyone figure out why in America it's in February? Well, in America, the month of February was chosen because of the birthday of Abraham Lincoln being on the 12th of February and Frederick Douglass on February the 14th. Both of these dates were already important to the black communities and they'd celebrated them together since the 19th century. Wee task for you. I want you to find out why Abraham Lincoln and Frederick Douglass were important to black people in America. As I said at the start, throughout history there have been lots of really, really famous black people who have done amazing things. Can anyone maybe tell me, or tell your teacher I should say, the name of any black people that you know that have done amazing things, whether it's sportsmen and women, film stars? I want you to see how many famous black people you can come up with. I'm going to start you off. Barack Obama used to be the president of the United States. I think that's pretty famous. So there's a starter. How many can you come up with? The next few slides are going to go through some of the famous black people. I don't know if you would have identified some of them, but let's go through some of them. This first one is somebody called Mary Sicoli, and she went to help soldiers in the Crimean War, and because of all her efforts, the soldiers called her Mother Sicoli, as she comforted them, nursed them back to health, and was always there if they needed clean clothes and blankets and kindness. Rosa Parks. Now, Rosa Parks was very, very famous. And she became famous because she was sitting on a bus one day and she refused to give up her seat to a white person just because of the colour of her skin. And she was actually arrested by the police and fined for breaking the rules. Other people, white and black, agreed with Rosa and made it clear to the American government that it wasn't right that a black person had to give up their seat for a white person. And they eventually managed to change the rule that black people no longer had to sit in a separate section of a bus. So well done to Rosa Parks. Nelson Mandela. Now, you'll have heard me speaking about Nelson Mandela before. I think he is just a wonderful man, or he was a wonderful man. But he was the first ever black South African president. And he had spent 27 years in prison fighting for what he believed was right and equal for black people. Many, many people around the world thought he was a hero and respected him for his courage and his wisdom. And he went on to unite the country of South Africa, bring them together, whereas previously they were divided by hate. Alice Coachman was an African-American athlete who did the high jump. And in London, in 1948, she became the first black woman to win an Olympic gold medal. There was Jesse Owens. Again, he was another American athlete. He was known as the Buckeye Bullet, and he was American track and field. And he took part in the 1936 Olympic Games and won 4 gold medals. 100 metres, the long jump, the 200 metres and the 400 metre relay. Hitler, because back in 1936, close to the start of World War II, he wanted the Games to be a display of German white supremacy, but Owens, along with other black athletes, they showed him that actually nobody is better than anybody else and won many, many medals. Oprah Winfrey. Now, Oprah Winfrey has been famous for years. She has her own talk shows. She does a lot of charity work. She helps a lot of poor and disadvantaged people. And at the age of 17, she went to university and began working in radio and television. From 86 to 2011, she hosted her own talk show, and it was aired in more than 100 countries worldwide. She's also broken into the world of film, starring and producing many successful films. Benjamin Zephaniah is a British poet and human and animal rights activist. He was born in Birmingham, and when he was little, he wrote his own poetry, as he didn't find what he was learning at school reflected him and his culture and the fact that he was black. His poetry is strongly influenced by the music and poetry of Jamaica, and he also writes poetry for children who find his work inspiring and accessible. Wonder if you could find any of Benjamin Zephaniah's work. Barack Obama. Now, he was born in Hawaii in August 1961. His father was from Kenya and his mother was from Kansas. And in 2008, he became the 44th American president, the first African-American president in the United States. Bishop Wilfred Wood became the first black bishop of the Church of England. In 2004, the British people voted him second in the 100 Great Black Britons list. He's worked hard to help with the relationships between people of different colours living in the United Kingdom. So who can say now why we celebrate Black History Month? Has your idea changed from what you've just heard today? Everyone is equal, and nobody deserves to be treated differently. Miss B's shout out. Say it loud. Yeah. Some people say we got a lot of malice. Some say it's about us. But I say we want to quit moving until we get what we deserve. We've been built and we've been scorned. We've been treated bad, talked about, as you and you moan. Just as you as it takes you eyes to make a pair. Brother, we can't quit. Till we get our share. Say it loud. Say it loud. One more time. Say it loud. I've worked on jobs with my feet in my hands. You know, all the work I did was for the other man. Now we demand a chance to do things for ourselves. We're tired of beating our head against the wall and working with someone else. Say it loud. Say it loud. Say it loud. Say it loud. Say it loud.
Stars of the Week.
Welcome to Stars of the Week for this week, and what a busy week it is. So the first one goes to Molly O, Lily M and Gosha, all in P6, for your commitment to your learning. You are superstars. Keep up the hard work. Girls, I am absolutely delighted to hear that. Well done. Then we have Sky, Tori and Chanel. You've been working really hard this week and your efforts are appreciated. Well done, guys. Absolutely well done to you. Primary 6 have clearly been very busy this week. Well done. Next one, Primary 1C, goes to Hallie for being committed to taking part in all aspects of home learning. Well done, Hallie. Well done indeed. Considering it was your big brother that got it last week, so well done to you, Hallie. P2 for in school, this goes to Darcy for being a fantastic listener all week. Darcy, that is such good news. Well done to you, Toots. And then at home, Tamara, well done for producing lovely home learning work. Tamara, absolutely delighted. Keep up the good work. Well done. Then we have Megan in P4D, who you've already seen, for sharing her excellent kickboxing skills with the class live from her living room. Amazing. Absolutely. Also for her fantastic effort with home learning. Megan, well done. Very, very proud of you. And I was very impressed. Don't know if Shane was very impressed at how hard you were hitting his hands in those pads. Then we've got Murdo in P4B, who you also saw, for sharing his excellent workouts with his class, both in school and live from his living room. Amazing. Maybe we've got a new Joel Wicks on our hands. I don't know. Well done, Murdo. Max in P4B for tremendous commitment at home and in school to his learning tasks. Well done to you, Max. Very proud of you. And Jasmine in P4D. Wow, Primary 4 has been busy. For fantastic effort and commitment to the online learning tasks and lessons. I did see you online, Jasmine. Absolutely brilliant. Well done to you. Michael in P6 for super participation in foot golf. Take it, that's from Mr. J. Michael, I'm absolutely delighted. Well done. Ruri in P2S for trying hard in football skills. Well done to you, Ruri. P5 online, this goes to Connor and Haley for exceptional work and engaging in all teams lessons and meetings. Now, Mrs. Hill has put a wee note at the side there and said, it was really hard to pick this week as lots of people's online in P5 are doing a great job. I couldn't agree more. Well done, and well done to you, Connor and Haley. P5, Hannah. Now, Hannah has been in school for amazing effort in all work this week and always being kind. I totally agree. Well done to you, Hannah. And whoa, lo and behold, big sister gets one too. This one goes to Mariana for giving 100% effort in all areas of her work. Thank you. Absolutely. Well done to you, Mariana. I hope the pair of you are getting some sort of treat for being so amazing this week and both getting stars. Well done. P3, Grace, for an absolutely fantastic effort this week. Grace, well done. And I even saw you online helping your wee brother with the nursery teams chat. So well done to you. P3, Libby, for getting involved in all aspects of online learning and working like a trooper. I agree. I saw your look of absolute joy and delight at being online in a meeting the other day. So well done to you, Libby. P7, Niamh, that's Niamh K, for fantastic, super work this week. You are a star. Well done to you, Niamh. No, don't worry, I'm not going to sing the song, but well done. Absolutely brilliant. This one is actually from me, and it goes to Mr. Solomon for always being positive, working hard, and helping anyone who needs it. Thank you, Mr. Solomon. I know that I can just ping you a text message or ping you an email and you will absolutely do what you can to help providing IT stuff for families. So thank you. And the final one for today goes to Calvin in P1 and Carson in P5 for being wee fighters and doing so well on the road to recovery. And welcome home, Calvin. We're looking forward to getting you both back into school as soon as we possibly can. And we are all, as always, sending our love and keeping you both in our prayers. So that's Stars of the Week for this week. Lovely to see so many different people getting the Stars of the Week. It is actually the highlight of my week, doing Stars of the Week at every assembly. So well done to one and all. Your name might not be up here, but you're all stars. I decided that today we're going to sing a song that we haven't sung before, but it's one that I think sums up beautifully what I think of everyone at the moment and how well they are all doing. So enjoy.
I've paid my dues time after time. I've done my sentence but committed no crime. And bad mistakes I've made a few.
Well, that's all for assembly this week, guys. Now, remember, next week is Child Mental Health Week. So our assembly next week will be called Express Yourself. So all that's left for me to say is have a lovely weekend. Look after each other. Stay safe. and we'll see you next week. Bye, guys.